Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. Today we visit the smallest distillery in Scotland, the Edradour Distillery. Through the distillery flows the small river called the Edradour Burn. The distillery is open for public, a very nice place to see the distilling business, and has a small shop where you can find all the Edradour whiskies. We start at the reception and make our way up through the halls that are now being used as tasting rooms. This tasting room is enlightened by a very big round brass plate that has been previously used in the whiskey production. This is the Edradour Burn. The water for the whiskey production comes from the small spring called Ben Vraki. The Edradour River divides the distillery into two parts that you can reach via a bridge in the middle of the distillery. This here is the main production building. It includes the distilling, malting, mashing, fermentation, as well as the malt mill. Here is the entrance to the building. A forklift is carrying the big sacks of malt into the building where they are grinded down. The heat exchangers that you can see here right now that take out the energy from the condensers are very, very old. A nice story. The metal worker that refurbished these tubes in 2004 found out that his grandfather had built the original tubes. Edradour used to malt their own barley. They still have the malting floors and the kiln to roast the malt, but they're not in active production anymore. The Edradour malt is a non-peated malt, but a new brand, the Balachin, comes from the Edradour distillery and is the peated counterpart to the Edradour whiskey. This now is the malt mill. It grinds down the malt into a coarse grist. Before that, the malt is being sieved to remove any excess parts. The grist is then transferred to the left into the mash tun at the ground floor. We now look through the window into the still room. These two wooden buttons are the low wines receiver. Here you see a cooler and the low wines receiver from the other direction. The tall one is the top of the wash still and the small one is the top of the spirit still. This here is the inside of the mash tun. It extracts all the sugar from the malt and now the liquid is ready for the wash bag for fermentation. Currently the mash tun is half full and being emptied. This here is the spirit receiver, and at the end of the building we now see the two wash bags. Be careful when you look inside a wash bag. The alcoholic fumes and the CO2 that is being produced are a dangerous mixture. It can knock you unconscious in a matter of seconds. Here you can see how deep the wash bags are. The still room is very small and it feels crowded even if there are only a few people inside, as it is so small. The Edradour whiskey is so popular that these small stills, like this wash still here, has to run 24/7 and 365 days a year. Through this watch glass you can see the wash boiling. This is now the spirit still. The spirit still has a reflux bowl to make the whiskey smoother. And this is now what it's all about. The new make spirit coming out of the spirit still. We now leave the still house as we have seen all the production steps. Now we leave the still house and head for the New Caledonian Hall. This building is the old malting building, where the barley is turned into malt. You can always recognize it by the kiln. On the right you have the bar, then the river, and then you have the still house with the ware entrance. This here is now the New Caledonian Hall, a hall right next to the dunnage so you can see through the windows how the whisky matures. We walked up the river for about a minute, and now we found ourselves at the entrance of the Edradour Dunnage. The Edradour Dunnage is really big compared to the size of the distillery. It also has casks from a lot of other distilleries, as the owner is Andrew Symington, who is the owner, also the owner of the independent bottling Signatory Vintage. The cask variation in the Edradour Dunnage is really, really great, as Edradour has so many different releases of sherry, masala and other wine casks from all over the world. Oh look, a cask from the Lafroig distillery. The collection and the finishing in so many different casks is kind of a hobby of the owner Andrew Symington. And we, the whisky connoisseurs, profit from this great variety of whisky finishes. Here we see our Edradour working, taking a sample from a cask and pouring it into a bottle. Now we look inside the warehouse from the New Caledonian Hall. The New Caledonian Hall includes a big hall with a lot of tables to hold events in and a bar that serves only Edradour single malt Scotch whisky. Thank you for watching and subscribe for more videos.